In this lesson, we are going to learn how to control this smart car with our hand. When your hand moves to the left, it turns to the left. Your hand moves to the right, it turns to the right. And also at certain distance, if you put it in front of it, it follows your hand.
If it is around 5 centimeters, you see 7 centimeters, it's going forward. And if we have only in one of them, it goes to the right. And I bring my hand to the left. Welcome to Arduino course by Robojax. This course is based on SunFounder 3-in-1 Arduino kit sold on Amazon. Everything that you learn in this course is included in this kit. The course comes with tons of components and projects, all with instruction and video for smart car and other projects that you can use for school or home automation. You can purchase it from sunfounder.com. The kit also comes with full documentation, code download, learning projects with full explanation, wiring diagram, and the code that you can download. The link to purchase the kit and documentation is below the video in the description. This is a project page. If you come to car projects, it's number 7, follow your hand. We already know everything about this. Wiring is already done. So we are using infrared sensors and ultrasonic sensors. The wiring, everything have been explained in previous lessons. We are just going to jump into code and demonstration. Now let's open the project. Click on file, open. Go inside that 3-in-1 kit main and then click on car projects. Go number 7, click on number 7, follow your hand, click and open. And here is a code, let me explain it. This is the same exactly as before. Define 4 pins for the car. These 2 are for one motor, these are for the other motor, these 2 are for left and right infrared sensor, these are for the ultrasonic, for ping and trigger. And then I've defined, this is extra, I've defined here a variable called moving. So initially it's false, and then we are defining the serial monitor. Here this is, again, we are defining the pins as an output for motor, and these are for obstacle avoidance. This was missing. I've taken this from the code for ultrasonic sensor, so echo and ping. Pin one is as input, the other is as an output. They have been defined here. Inside the loop, we are reading the distance using read sensor data. This is exact code from the previous lesson, and these are also the same code from infrared, where we get the distance using this function, and using these 2, we are getting the left and right detection of obstacle. If it is obstructed, if the hand is there, we will read 0, otherwise it will be empty. And this is the speed we have defined. And here I have changed the code here because the code had some issue, it was not working. So this portion is exactly the same. We check if the distance is greater than 5 and less than 10, which means between 5 and 10. Then we move forward with this speed, passing it to this function, which you have seen it in the speed or controlling the car lesson. And then we say else stop, which means if it's not between 5 and 10 centimeters, stop. Even if it's short, also stop. If it is long, stop. Now, the car is stopped if no hand is there. Now here, this was part of the code, but I've removed something from the bottom. If there is an obstacle or the hand is there, because this means there is nothing. And if you put this, it means there is something. So if there is an obstacle, then turn left, because the right is nothing and there is something on the left. So we turn left with the speed. If on the left side there is nothing and there is an obstacle or hand on the right side, then we turn right. And Also, this was missing in the code, like in the previous ultrasonic code. If you don't add this 100 millisecond delay, you will not be able to measure the distance because the sensor needs some time, at least 100 milliseconds, to measure. So this is the exact code as before. We don't need to even explain it because I have already explained this. You must watch that video. This is for forward, backward, turn right, and turn left. In each function, I've added the text. For example, for the stop, it prints on the serial monitor, stop. For the left, it prints left. For the turn right, it prints right. And for backward, it prints reverse. And for forward, forward. And here I've added these two lines to print the distance. The code demonstration, as you can see, it shows the distance around 36 centimeters. And because the object is 36 centimeters away, it's not doing anything now, right now. So let me put my hand here. As soon as you see that the distance is 8 centimeters between 5 and 10, it's forward. So this is supposed to go now forward. And if I remove it, it will stop. My hand is on the left side, it goes on the left and stop. It goes to the left and stop. And if it is an obstacle is on the right, it goes to the right and stops. Now, so I'm holding it up, it doesn't move. And if I bring my hand in here, let me bring my hand from the bottom. If it is around 5 centimeters, you see 7 centimeters, it's going forward. And if we have only in one of them, it goes to the right. And also it shows here, right? Now, if I bring my hand to the left, you see it says left and then stop. And in the same time, if it is less than this, it will stop. Less than 5 centimeters, and as soon as it's above more than 5, it will go forward. And now here is the demonstration. I will put my hand from the top so you can see it. And as soon as it detects my hand, it follows. But if my hand is too far, it's not doing anything. As soon as it reaches less than between 2 to 10 centimeters, it follows. But if I bring my hand here on the left or right, okay, so if I go left, if I go right, it follows the hand. If I go to the right, it goes to the right because this sensor is detecting my hand. If I put my hand, go forward, it follows. So, as you can see, it's working as expected. Okay, we get just a word.